If you're going to explore space or alien worlds, you're going to want to have your open source science tricorder-like device, the ArduCorder Mini. As a scientist, I strongly believe that knowledge and discovery bring about positive change and help us make positive social choices like reducing our emissions or working towards cleaner industry in our communities. That's why I designed the ArduCorder Mini, a pocket-sized Arduino-compatible general sensing tool with a dozen different kinds of sensors. The idea is to help us discover more about the world around us and make little discoveries everywhere. The ArduCorder has modular sensor boards and a CC3000 Wi-Fi module for uploading data to Plotly, which is this beautiful website that's like social media for data and lets you instantly share your readings with your friends or colleagues. I've designed the interface to play off the idea of live tiles, where here nearly every tile contains live sensor data. This allows the user to quickly and intuitively scroll through the data from every sensor in only a few seconds and zoom in on interesting data by selecting a tile. Now this is really cool. There's a large amount of data here from very different sensors, and it's great to be able to get an overview of an environment in only a few seconds. So here we're going to select the inertial measurement tile, which gives us data from the accelerometers and the gyros. And we can see here that the graph display has historical motion data that's auto-scaling, so if I shake the device, the tiny movements from being in my hand are dwarfed by this significant motion. Now we can also connect to Plotly, which allows us to stream much of this data live to the Plotly servers. And once it's connected, anyone with a web browser can watch the data stream in real time. So for example, if we scroll over to the magnetic field sensor, we can watch the ArduCorder sense the small magnetic field given off by this magnetic screwdriver. And we can also watch that data stream in live on Plotly. So here on the Plotly website, we're looking at the magnetic field stream, where we can see the total magnetic field strength, as well as the vector that would let us calculate the direction. We can also zoom in on that data that we just took and measure the maximum field strength at about 115 microtesla. Now there's lots of other streams here too. Here's the stream with the atmospheric pressure, temperature, and humidity. Here's a radiation level stream. And here's a motion stream with data from the accelerometers and gyros again. Now, if you don't mind me breaking down the fourth wall a bit, here we can see motion data from a few minutes before where I set up that last shot by picking up the ArduCorder from the desk and placing it in a different orientation on some books. Now, something really cool, if we compare the streams, we can see that as soon as I moved the ArduCorder, the ambient radiation level went down, likely because it went from being flat on the desk where it could more efficiently detect the terrestrial and cosmic background to standing up, where it's a little less efficient at that. Now, speaking of radiation, last year I started designing this open source CAT scanner and making low resolution scans of foods like this bell pepper. The ArduCorder uses the same photodiode based radiation sensor that we see here that the CT scanner uses to detect its barium-133 radioisotope source. And if we place the ArduCorder on the table, we can see that the radiation level inside the bore is about 500 counts per minute, or about 100 times over background. Outside the bore near the source, we can see that this level is only about 50 counts per minute, which means that all that lead is doing its job. Now for me, one of the coolest parts about this sensor is that it's technically sensitive to energy level, so I added in this tile that displays a histogram of the detection pulse widths. By comparing the histogram fingerprint from this barium-133 source with this cadmium-109 source through the magic of Plotly, here we can see that they're quite different and start to measure not only the radiation level, but also what radioactive compound might be generating it. The ArduCorder includes the Hamamatsu microspectrometer, which is a tiny visible spectrometer with a little UV and IR coverage. Here we see the blackbody spectrum of an incandescent bulb and the solar spectrum for comparison. Now I don't know a lot about plants, but I'd like to, and I'd like to measure the health of these three leaves. After a bit of reading, I found a spectroscopic measure called the photochemical reflective index and put together these tiles. Now for show for this educational experiment, we're not going to use a sample container, and we're going to pretend that this paper is perfectly reflective for calibration, so we're more interested in the relative changes instead of the absolute number. With this first leaf that's just starting to turn, we can see that the photochemical reflective index is about 0.14. Next, with this very healthy looking leaf, we can see that this nearly doubles to about 0.26. And finally, with this nearly dead leaf, the number collapses down to about 0.06. Now the cool thing here is that a few hours before, I knew very little about healthy leaves, and with a bit of reading and this reconfigurable tool, I really hit the ground running. I believe that general scientific tools can change our knowledge of and our relationship with the world around us. And for this, I give you the ArduCorder Mini.